Growing up during the 1940s and 50s, this multi-talented athlete spent the summer on local diamonds playing first base and serving as a heavy hitter. During the winter, he could be found at the Amelia Street rink, developing the strong goaltending skills that would see him go on to enjoy a successful amateur and professional hockey career. His exceptional talent saw him signed by the Fort William Hurricane Rangers, and right from the start, he was a hit with the fans, tying with teammate Alex Delvecchio in the Junior Hockey Popular Player Poll. His final season with the Hurricanes would be a memorable one, defeating the Port Arthur Bruins 4-3 in Game 6 of the 1951-52 District Final in front of close to 6,000 fans packed into the Fort William Gardens. They advanced along the Memorial Cup Trail. Their next challengers were the Winnipeg Monarchs, champions of the Manitoba League. Winning 3 games and tying 2, they won the Interleague title, earning the chance to challenge the Regina Pats for Western Canada dominance. Although losing in the Memorial Cup Western Final 4-2, their success along the trail earned them a hometown parade and a civic reception. Turning professional with the Detroit Red Wings, he spent the 1952-53 season moving through various leagues. That wasn't uncommon for goalies during the days of the Original Six. In his first pro season, he guarded the nets for such teams as the Edmonton Flyers of the Western Hockey League, the St. Louis Flyers of the American Hockey League, and Quebec's Shawinigan Falls Cataracts. The majority of the 1953-54 season was spent with Sherbrooke of the Quebec Hockey League, and he once again proved to be a favorite, receiving the Lord Calvert Player of Distinction Award as the Saints' most valuable player, as voted on by the local sports media. It was also during that season that he would have his chance to play on NHL ice, and he did so in style. Called up to replace an injured Terry Sawchuk, he made his way to Detroit in a quickly organized trip from Quebec, and after very little sleep, donned the pads to face off against the Toronto Maple Leafs. When the final whistle blew, the visitors had not managed to get the puck past the rookie netminder, who had stopped 22 shots, including a breakaway by Ted Kennedy late in the third, recording a 4-0 shutout in his NHL debut. In his next game against Chicago, he protected a 2-0 lead going into the third period, establishing a rookie record of lasting 100 minutes and 21 seconds without letting in a goal. His third NHL game almost resulted in another shutout. The puck crossed the line in the last 4 seconds of play. Detroit went on to win the Stanley Cup that season. They were so appreciative of his efforts, they had his name engraved as part of the team's roster on the coveted trophy. With Sawchuk back in the lineup, Gatherum returned to the QHL and split the 1954-55 season between the Quebec Aces and the New Westminster Royals until he was sidelined by injury. Playing with the Kelowna Packers from 1955 through 1959, he once again emerged as a standout and a fan favorite. In 1956, he was picked up by the Vernon Canadiens for their successful Allen Cup playoff run. Throughout his time with the Packers, he was twice named an All-Star, he earned the lowest goals against average and team MVP honors, and helped the team advance to the 1958 Allen Cup Finals. In November of 1958, the Packers were selected to represent Canada on a European tour, and that included 3 games in Sweden, 5 games in Russia, becoming the first Canadian team to play behind the Iron Curtain. Foster Hewitt said the team had very little chance of winning even a single game, but they proved him wrong, with Gatherum's strong netminding being credited with leading them to a record of 2 wins, 2 losses, and a tie against the favorite Soviets. Returning to the Lakehead following that season, he passed along his knowledge to the next generation of hockey stars, serving as a manager and executive member for junior hockey. And it was while playing hockey in Kelowna, he had been introduced to the career that would see him make a name for himself in local business circles, operating Dave Gatherum Stationers for many years. In 2005, when the Stanley Cup was in Thunder Bay, he had the chance to enjoy his day with the Cup, and in 2009, the Detroit Red Wings provided him with a Stanley Cup ring to commemorate the contributions that this exceptional netminder had made to the team's history during the days of the Original Six.